Welcome to Daily Scripture Reading. I do not own the rights to this music. Joshua chapter 4. This is the Amplified Version. Memorial Stones from Jordan. So it was, when all the nation had finished crossing the Jordan, the Lord said to Joshua, "Take for yourselves the 12 men chosen from among the people, one man from each tribe, and command them, 'Pick up for yourselves 12 stones, one each from here out of the midst of the Jordan, from the place where the priest's feet are standing, firm. Carry them over with you and lay them down at the place where you will spend the night tonight.' Then Joshua called the 12 men whom he had appointed from the sons of Israel, one man from each tribe, and Joshua said to them, 'Cross over again to the ark of the Lord your God into the midst of the Jordan, and each of you take up a stone on his shoulder according to the number of the tribes of the sons of Israel, so that this may be a sign among you when your children ask later, 'What do these stones mean to you?' Then you shall say to them that the waters of the Jordan were cut off before the ark of the covenant of the Lord. When it crossed the Jordan, the waters of the Jordan were cut off. So these stones shall become a memorial for Israel forever." So the 12 men chosen from the sons of Israel did as Joshua commanded, and took up 12 stones out of the midst of the Jordan, according to the number of the tribes of the sons of Israel, just as the Lord had spoken to Joshua. And they carried them over with them to the place where they were spending the night, and put them down there. Then Joshua set up a second monument of 12 stones in the midst of the Jordan, at the place where the feet of the priest who carried the Ark of the Covenant were standing, and they are there to this day. For the priests who carried the Ark were standing in the midst of the Jordan until everything was finished that the Lord had commanded Joshua to tell the people, in accordance with everything that Moses had commanded Joshua. The people hurried and crossed the dry riverbed, and when all the people had finished crossing, the ark of the Lord and the priests crossed over in the presence of the people, the sons of Reuben and the sons of Gad, and half the tribe of Manasseh, crossed over armed for battle before the other sons of Israel, just as Moses had spoken to them. About 40,000 men, armed and equipped for war, crossed for battle before the Lord to the desert plains of Jericho. On that day, the Lord magnified and exalted Joshua in the sight of all Israel, so they feared him with profound awe and reverence, just as they had feared Moses all the days of his life. Now the Lord said to Joshua, "Order the priests carrying the Ark of the Testimony to come up out of the Jordan." So Joshua commanded the priests, saying, "Come up out of the Jordan." When the priests who carried the Ark of the Covenant of the Lord had come up from the midst of the Jordan, and the soles of their feet were raised up to the dry land, the waters of the Jordan returned to their place and flowed over all its banks as before. Now the people came up from the Jordan on the 10th day of the first month, and encamped at Gilgal on the eastern border of Jericho. And those 12 stones which they had taken from the Jordan, Joshua set up in Gilgal. And he said to the sons of Israel, "When your children ask their fathers in time to come, 'What do these stones mean?' then you shall let your children know, 'Israel crossed this Jordan on dry ground, for the Lord your God dried up the waters of the Jordan for you until you crossed over, just as the Lord your God did to the Red Sea, which he dried up before us until we had crossed, so that all the peoples of the earth may know without any doubt and acknowledge that the hand of the Lord is mighty and extraordinarily powerful, so that you will fear the Lord your God and obey and worship him with profound awe and reverence forever." The end. God bless you and thank you for joining me today.